Hi children, welcome back. In the last video already we have learnt about many different parts of our bodies, isn't it? You know, you have been learning the different parts of our bodies from LKG, UKG, and even you are studying in this standard also. So in the last chapter we have learned the different parts of body and what are the uses of each part of the body. Then in today's video we are learning about how to protect our body parts, okay, or how to keep safe our body organs. For example, I'll give you simple example. So nowadays it's a rainy season. How do you protecting your body from the rainy season? Yes, tell me the answer. Yes, exactly. So while raining we should use a muffler, we should cover our ears, and we should use a sweater even in a rainy season and even in the winter season also. And while going outside, we should carry the umbrella or raincoat we should wear, because so by doing like this we can prevent, we can take care of our body with the rain, against the rain. So like this, in the winter season again we have to wear the cloths which we can keep our heart and this lungs very hot, and we have to maintain our body a temperature, like we can keep cotton in the ears, or we can cover always the head and the ear, and unnecessary we should not go out in the very cold climate, and we can avoid the traveling, because in the cold climate if we travel again there are possibility of getting ill, our there is a possibility of getting harm to our body. Then we can avoid as much as possible from us. So like this, in the rainy season and in the winter season we can avoid our we can take care of our body by avoiding some things. And even we can take care during this rainy season and even in the winter season also, we can take care of our skin, we can take care of our whole health and digestive system by adjusting the food we are preparing and food we are eating. We have to eat those foods which are suitable for those particular seasons. Like example, in the summer season we should eat a lot of the cold substances, like that may be any juice, or that may be only chapati, only rice. We should not eat the food which is going to generate the heat in our body. We should eat the food which contains the cold, or which maintains our, cools down our body temperature. Okay, in the summer season we must wear the cloths which are of cotton, made up of cotton. We should not use any synthetic or any polyester cloths, because those cloths have the property of again increasing the temperature. They will not decrease the temperature, again they will increase the temperature. By using the cotton and very thin cloths, by wearing those, so our body can maintain or our body can live out a lot of temperature. So it can, the temperature can be maintained, and body can, that cloth helps to keep the body cold. And even in the winter also we have seen, and even in the rainy season also we have seen what type of cloths we have to wear, and even we have seen the what type of food we have to eat during the summer season. And what about the rainy and the winter season? Of course, rainy and winter season, these are the two seasons where we can get very easily ill. Our health can get very easily ill because of the cold climate. We will get fever, we will get cold, cough, like this. It's a viral flu. It can be passed if one family member is ill, then automatically the whole family is going to be infected by that particular person. So because of that, we should go for, first of all, we should keep our body safe, and we should go for eating a very healthy food. We should not eat from outside, so that we can get easily the cough. So we can get the easily the cold by eating cold drinks. We should drink cold drinks, and we can eat the things which are going to keep our body cold in the summer season. But in the winter and the rainy season, we should eat the material, food material, so that they are going to give us the lot of body temperature to our body, that is hotness to the body. So can outside will be the cold, and inside if we generate the lot of temperature in our body, then the temperature is going to be balanced, then we can be very healthy. For example, you can eat the egg, you can eat the wheat items like chapati, like some paisa or sweet of made up of wheat. So you can use lot many like this, and you can eat oily food during this. Okay, oily food and fried food. So you can eat like this, and avoid most. Don't eat fried foods every day or every evening. So if you keep on eating like this, if you keep on eating the ghee and this oil content and some other fat contents every day in the three meals, again there is a possibility of getting illness. So you should see the proper time and proper amount of the substance which you can use in your food. So like this, by doing like this, we can maintain our health or body temperature, so we can take care of our body. Even you can do the same thing even in the rainy season also. Along with your body, you have to keep your brain, your mind also very peaceful, because that is a most important thing that is going to do, that is the just like a remote for every work, whatever we are doing, this brain is the just like a remote. Then we have to give lot many of positive things to our brain, not the negative things. Then we have to keep our body always like energetic, like happiness or like joyful. So we have to be like this. We have to involve ourselves in doing new things, so many attractive things, some of the innovative things. So if you keep on trying this, doing this all, automatically there will be an interest is going to generate in our body. So this is how, by doing. Then how you can do the give the positive energy to your body or your brain. So you may ask me the simple question. So along with your study, keep on doing your study regularly. Along with your study, you can go for a playing in a particular time. There must be a serious playing, okay, not simply going and wasting and running and coming to the home. There must be a serious playing according to the timetable. You should have a small goal that I should do this much. For example, if you are going for a running practice, there must be a step-by-step practice. For example, today you are going to run for a 1/2 kilometer. Okay, do practice this one for 2 to 3 days. Then after 3 days, there must be an improvement. After 1/2 kilometer, you may increase that running to the 1 kilometer. So like this, if your practice is very much serious, then there will be an interest created among yourself, which will make you to achieve something in the future or achieve something in the coming days. You can go for a regular exercise also. Playing, exercise, dancing, singing. Of course, these dancing and singings are hobbies also, and they are the just like remote to create interest within yourself, and which will give you a positive energy. Okay. I hope you all have, generally I have told you the some points. I hope you all have understood these all the points. In the next video, we are going to discuss about the organs of our particular organs of the body, then how we can take care of those. Okay, then I hope you have understood whatever we have discussed in this video. Before ending this video, I want to give you one simple question. You can write answer for that. The question is like this: how we can take care of our body during the summer season? Okay, how we can take care of our body during the summer season? You can write this only one question also, and you can otherwise, if you are interested, you can write all the three seasons how we are going to take care of our body. I hope you will do this homework. In the next video, again we are going to discuss about the next body organs and how to keep them safe. Okay, bye.